Hello everyone, take some pink cloth, make multiple strips out of it and cut it almost till the end of it. Now once you're done with this, take the different pieces and separate them. Insert black cloth in the middle of each of them. Add a ruler across it, then using the chalk, make lines across it as such. Now once again, stitch it all together and then rotate the pieces as such alternatively. Now stitch it up and it should look like a chessboard. Take the chalk again and then make these diagonal lines on either side of it and then make this curved line for it as well from the top. Move over to the bottom and make a curved line at the bottom as such. Lift it upwards. Now cut off all of the pieces you have created, put it on another pink cloth and then cut it up according to the shape. Make two strips, one out of pink, one out of blue. In the bottom, make two diagonal lines as such. Make two cuts across it as well. Now use this little pointed machine and then cut through it as such. Now turn it around and then make two crosses onto the other side. Stitch it together after making a little slit. Afterwards, take a pink strip of cloth and then stitch it together in order to make these frills. Now add this to the top of your initial creation and then cut off the excess. Make sure you sew it on. Now add another pink cloth on top of this in reverse, make a little pocket onto it as well and stitch the two pieces together. Make sure that it's stitched perfectly fine and then it is the right shape and size. Bend it over before you stitch it. Once you are done with the sides, you may reverse it and then add another piece to it. Do the same with this as well. Sew the two pieces together as shown in the video. Do it all around. Now, once you are done stitching it all around, move on to the pink portion of it, adjust this as well and once again sew all around it. Cut off the excess amount of thread. Bring the pink cloth above it and now sew this portion on from the bottom first. Now, reverse your entire cloth and this is what you should be left with. Now once you are done with this, take another purple cloth and then begin to sew this onto the top of the pink. It will add another layer to the frills as such. Now take this, wrap it around and once again begin to sew it accordingly. You should leave a little gap because of this. Do this until you reach the end of the cloth and make sure that you sew this into it. This will be the handle of the bag. Now after this, reverse it, take another purple piece of cloth and repeat the same step. Push it through, bend it over and then sew it through. Now you are left with a bag. You may use it for any purpose and you may make it in any shape or size as desired by you. You may also use any colors as per your wishes. Should you like to, you may also create little pockets on the inside or even on the outside. Next, we will start off by taking a black t-shirt as such. Cut out the top in a U shape. Now, once you're done with this, make a little V-shape cut onto your U and then take out a strip of it in the middle. Cut off the excess as such. Now, take the bits of your cloth and then put them underneath as such, starting with the sleeves. Cut out a little strip of it and then join it in the center. Afterwards, take your longer strip and then cut it up and then put it on the top. Now, putting all of these pieces together, begin to stitch it one on top of the other as such. You may use a sewing machine in order to do so. Join the two pieces together of the two sleeves and then continue to sew it together. Now, take these and then add it under the skirt-like shape you've created, join all of them together, and you are left with a little baby skirt with leg warmers. You may measure the size before you do so. Now, out of the remaining piece of cloth that is left, you may make it look like a beanie by stitching the corners of it. Next, we will start off by taking the somewhat triangular piece out of some cloth. Once you have cut it out, take a yellow cloth and then put it at the top of it. Measure the size of it and then according to the size that you have obtained, cut out a strip of cloth according to that size. Once you have done this, take it and then make another similar shaped cloth and then stick it on top of it. After cutting out all of these shapes, cut out a white strip of cloth as well and then stick it on top of this. This will be the lining. Put the same onto a brown cloth and then cut out the same shapes. After this, sew the two together like this. Reverse it and then sew it together. Do the same for the other piece, put one on top of the other and then cut out the excess portions of it. Now, once you are done with this, join them together, add them onto your initial portion, add a little nose and then make out of chalk little beads as such. This will make the mouth. Afterwards, take this other triangular shape and then take the brown silky portion of the cloth and stitch the two together. Take the other strip as well, stitch it together and then add a yellow cloth to the other side of it as such and sew it together. Now, using your marker, make two lines on the either side, fold your initial piece into half as such. Using the chalk, make two markers right through the center as such. Add all of them together, that is all of the pieces together, and sew it together as such. Do this all around and then once you are done with it, this is what it should look like. Add the other piece to it as well and then sew all of it together. Add a ribbon-like structure to it and this is what you should be left with. Reverse it once you are done and this is what it should look like. Fluff it out. Now take a needle and thread and then you may stitch this on or glue it on. Take another circular bit of paper, scrunch it up and then add it to the back as a little nose. Now open and close your zip as you please and then you may insert anything that you want into it. You have made yourself a little bag. Should you want to, you may also add a little handle to it on either side. You may hand sew this on yourself. This needn't be done with a sewing machine. Once again, you may choose to do this in any color as you please. Next, take a little strip of black cloth. After you have taken this black cloth, add it onto a pair of jeans and then cut off the excess. Now, take this pair, add two strips on either side, and then using a sewing machine, make a line through the center and sew the two together at the sides. Fold it over before you sew it. Now, slightly reverse it as such and bring it back to the right side. Sew the two together using the sewing machine. Now, once you're done with this, repeat the same process onto the other side and then add this onto your black cloth. Now, sew these two together. Start off with the smaller side and then move on to the longer length, and then do this on all three sides and finally do the last side. Now, leave a little bit unstitched and then afterwards, reverse the entire cloth using this portion. Once you reverse the cloth, this is what it should begin to look like. Flatten it out. Now, use a ruler and then mark it using this chalk. Do this on either side, make multiple strips on it. Now, take some thread, wrap it around your finger as such. Roll it together and then stitch it on using the sewing machine. Once again, repeat the step. Wrap it around and then stitch it onto the other side, right beside it. Continue to do this at the top. Now, keep doing it one beside the other as such. Do this until you reach the entire side and then do this with green cloth as well. Afterwards, do this with multiple colors. We have used orange and then brown once again, and then green and once again orange. You may also do it with different colors. Now, roll up the top as such and then once again, put it under the sewing machine and stitch it up in place. Make two lines using your chalk. Afterwards, sew these two lines down as well. This will help all of it stay put. Now, once you're done with this, do this on either side. Reverse it and then add the handle of a mop to it, and then you should be able to mop your floors with this. Thank you for watching.